are going to begin our ceremony. My name is Marina Brennan, and I am the NHS sponsor. And we will actually begin with Ms. Jaden Vines, our NHS president.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jaden Vines, and as president of National Honor Society, it is my pleasure to welcome everyone here tonight. We are very excited about our program this evening and hope that you will enjoy yourselves and remain to share refreshments with us at the end of the program. On behalf of the current membership of the Homewood Flossmoor chapter of National Honor Society, I would like to welcome our new members, their families, and friends here this evening. I would also like to thank our superintendent, Dr. Mansfield, our principal, Dr. Anderson, and our school board members who are here with us, Ms. Berman and Mr. Anderson. And if there are any other board members here tonight, could you all wave? Cool. Your support and guidance is crucial to the success of NHS. Our purpose in being here tonight is to honor and celebrate the induction of our members. Membership in the National Honor Society has been earned by the effective demonstration of the four qualities held in high esteem by the organization. Our current officers will take a moment to speak about each of these. Please join me in welcoming our secretary, Abigail Guerrero, who will now speak about the quality of service.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. While most of you may know me as Alex, at this formal occasion, I ask that you please call me by my government name, Abigail Margaret Guerrero. Jokes aside, I am the secretary of the NHS chapter and privileged to speak at such an admirable event. Whether you're here for the first time or the last, congratulations are in order for your academic achievements that brought each of you here. Before I officially congratulate everyone, I think it's important to take a step back and first acknowledge the journey that brought us here. If you take a look around, you will most likely notice that the students here look very different. To some, it may even feel like just a few years ago when we were born into our unique households. We called various kinds of people mom or dad, sometimes even by accident. We were growing and learning and, of course, fighting with siblings. Fast forward down the road, when we're trying to balance school, soccer practices, playing the violin, and still fighting with siblings, we pack onto our plate so much more than we can handle, but we'll never admit it. Ooh, I just lost my space. At the end of a few short years, we get so excited about the eighth grade dance, but then so embarrassed when our moms force us to take pictures with them. To all the moms in the audience, we see you. We know who you are. Soon enough, we take on the first day of freshman year, where, let's be real, most of us have no idea what we're doing. We handle things day by day and hope that everything will fall into place. We depend on our family and our friends to be patient with us as we make this transition from caterpillar to butterfly, and maybe even give us a little nudge when we're hanging in the chrysalis too long. To all the parents in the room, listen closely. I'm only going to say it just this once. You were right. As we grow older, we continue to learn that we can't handle everything just quite on our own. And that's okay, because what you give to your community, it will give back to you. When I first heard the saying, "It takes a village to raise a child," I thought that was just a nice way of my parents telling me I was a lot to handle. And I was wrong. Well, not about being a lot to handle, but the other part. While as individuals we may be strong, when you bring together honorable students, brilliant teachers, guiding families, and other influential members of the community, we become unstoppable. It's at this time that I ask everyone to please take a look to your left. Go on. And again to your right. In front of you. And behind you. Congratulations, you just graduated bobblehead school. Okay, seriously though, raise your hand if one of those people is someone that you don't know. Okay, get them up. I would like each of you to pick one person and just give them a quick compliment, whether it's the way you like whether you like the way they style their hair or like their shirt. To your benefit in the future. Basically, what I'm saying is that everybody here should add me on LinkedIn. Some of you got that. The concept here is fairly simple. Yet, if you still haven't caught on, here's a quick recap for you, physics style. In a chain, the force of tension is equally distributed among all of the links. Each of the links has its own very cold threshold point before it reaches a breaking point. The moment the tension reaches the breaking point of the weakest link, the chain will break. So just a gentle reminder to support all your links. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your time. And please give me a welcome.
Chapter. This evening, I will be speaking about character and its impact on our NHS organization. People are not born with character. It is something that is created, nurtured, and grows over time. The qualities that make a person moral and virtuous are the qualities that stand out the most. And one of the most common factors amongst all of our NHS members is that they have impeccable character. And National Honor Society is not only about serving our community, but holding yourself accountable in and out of school. All of you, current and incoming members, have proven yourselves to have character when people are watching and when they're not watching, but more importantly, true, when no one is. This organization is dependent on its members. Without you, nothing would ever get done, honestly, that's really true. And your persistence and willingness to help others shows within our school, within our communities, and especially within your families, and really shows up as how, what exemplary people you are. The past year has showcased the astronomical talent, passion, and determination of all our NHS members of the 2018-2019 school year. There are multitudes of events within the school and within our community that NHS headed, and without the consistency and dependence of our members, there would be no way that this organization would have made or make as much progress as it had and still does. That is where true character comes into play. All of the students in NHS are driven by something, whether it's helping others or scrambling to get their hours complete. I know who you are. And no matter what the case, they're always prepared for more. If something pops up and a teacher needs 4 helpers before the end of the day, there are 8 members ready to assist. These truly exceptional young adults display a level of maturity and responsibility that changes and enhances our program. New inductees, the position that you will now have will show the school and our community at large what you are capable of. You have to push yourself and be the best version of yourself possible because it is what will lead this organization to its success as it has in the past. And to the NHS members moving on, shine your light wherever you go. Your character is what people used to judge. So allow others to see astonishing people, what astonishing people you all are, inside and out. In closing, I hope you all realize that without the students, this program wouldn't be possible. And without the amazing character that each and every one of you displays, this program would not triumph. So we, being the executive board, the school, and the community, thank you all so much for your hard work and your dedication to this organization. Thank you.
Searcher for consent. consensus, but a molder of consensus. Dr. King, an admirable and honorable leader, knew that in order to be an effective leader, you have to open your ears before you open your mouth. The National Honor Society has provided members with the opportunity to listen to the concerns and needs of people in our community and respond accordingly. In the 2018-2019 school year, 183 students became, grew into, or were introduced to what it takes to be a leader. And it not only means taking care of your needs and wants, but considering what is best for the group as a whole. Webster's Dictionary defines a leader as the person who leads or commands a group, organization, or country. Every member here has led, commanded, and determined the success of this organization. Without members of NHS, our MLK Day of Service event in the Homewood-Flossmoor area would not have been a success. Because of the members of NHS, the book drive that was only supposed to happen once has become an annual event that will allow children in underserved communities around the world to have the opportunity to read the same books we read as children. The members in this room, and the ones who aren't, commended this organization and led us to massive success. Without this group's authentic passion for service, our community would be a very different place. NHS members have walked into the classrooms of Western Avenue, Heather Hill, Serena Hills, and Flossmoor Hills and taught students what it means to be a leader. By installing this mentality of success and dedication into the minds of children in this community, our NHS members are teaching the next batch of scholars, whether they know it or not. Seniors, the service, dedication, time, and effort you've put into this organization does not go unnoticed, and we applaud your proactivity. To the new inductees, know that the leader that is in each and every one of you will only grow through this program. NHS has a reputation of leaving an inspirational impact, and I know you all will continue to serve the community in the capacity we all know you are capable of. One of the most awe-inspiring women of our era, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, said, "Fight for the things that you care about, but do it in a way that will lead others to join you." The point of this organization is to inspire the world's future leaders, and I wholeheartedly believe that every student in this room has the potential to be an astounding person. Thank you.
Scholarship. Seniors, I presume that this is a generally familiar term for us, considering that our parents have been nagging us to apply for them seemingly every minute of every hour for the past year and a half. But this speech is finally not about that type of scholarship. No, this speech is about the other type of scholarship. This is more about, as learners, your ability to find meaning in the world around you. This pursuit goes far beyond the grades each of you receives in school, even though your scholastic achievement is impressive and must be recognized. Scholarship in NHS relates to students that are curious and strive to see how the world outside of school connects to the work they do in the classroom. And each and every one of you here is an outstanding example of that trait. In high school and college, we have to study certain topics because it's required of us, either to graduate or complete a particular degree program. This alone is not scholarship. Scholarship is pursuing something that you personally are interested in, seeking to understand and to learn, not because you have to, but because you want to. There are so many incredible things in life to be discovered that you cannot find in the halls or in the classrooms of an academic institution. Scholarship is going out there into the world, maybe with nothing but a pen and an open mind, and experiencing all of it, chasing your passions and searching for greater understanding of something that you individually wholeheartedly find captivating and fascinating and inspiring because you want to know more. And you don't have to do it through academics. You can seek understanding through science and math and philosophy, but you can also do so through religious devotion, through artistic discovery, through travel to foreign lands, through conversation with people with different values than yourself. Nelson Mandela once said, "A good head and a good heart are always a formidable combination. But when you add to that a literate tongue or pen, then you have something very special." This connects perfectly to the values we cherish here in the Homewood-Flossmoor High School chapter of the National Honor Society. This desire to attach good intentions and service to the high ceiling you all have as students and people is why you are here tonight being recognized as future pioneers who will make a difference and who will change the world. I know you might be skeptical right now and thinking to yourself, well, I'm one kid out of millions. What am I really going to do? You guys are what, 15, 16, 17, or even 18 years old? Well, you're all here right now because you have already demonstrated time and time again that there is no bound to what you can achieve academically and what you can apply that to in school and out. Just give it a few years and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. Though you may not flaunt it to your peers or even realize that you have it in the first place, your love of learning in school is a truly special trait to have that you should all take pride in having, and that is scholarship in its truest form. I would now like to introduce our guest speaker, Laurence Holmes, class of 1993. Mr. Holmes began his professional career at Homewood Flossmoor High School, where he hosted his own radio program on WHFH. Mr. Holmes then attended DePaul University, where he interned for WMAQ Radio and worked at WGN Channel 9 for Dan Rohn and Rich King. He graduated from DePaul with a degree in communications, where he has since returned as an adjunct professor at the university's College of Communications. At 22, Mr. Holmes began producing Chicago sports icon Les Grobenstein's Overnight Show. For the past 20 years, he has served as executive producer, host, and reporter on 670 AM. His career has expanded to include a daily sports podcast for radio.com. Mr. Holmes is especially known for his well-informed yet personable style during his interviews with athletes, coaches, and other sports journalists. In recent years, Mr. Holmes has called 5A and 6A Illinois state football games and has been featured as an on-air sports reporter with NBC Channel 5.
Thank you very much to everyone here. I'm so honored to be welcomed back here. And the reason is because this place means a lot to me. I grew up on the South Side. I grew up in the Roseland area. Before my freshman year of high school, my parents moved us out to Glenwood. And I had to enter a whole new world filled with new expectations in an area that I had nothing to do with. So when I got out here, I was trying to find myself. And trying to find yourself as you're walking in to high school in a new place, extremely difficult. So what I thought was going to happen, because I was a pretty good athlete in grammar school, I thought I would come to HF and set the world on fire. And then I got hurt freshman year playing basketball. I broke up my ankle pretty bad. I was in a cast for 6 months. And I didn't know what to do with myself. So I sat around the house, and my mother said to me, well, you really like talking about sports, so did you know that they have a radio station? I said, what? Because what high school has a radio station? Let alone the highest powered high school radio station in the country. So I started my journey as a broadcaster. I had the pleasure of having a bunch of amazing teachers in every subject, but specifically in broadcasting, and one of them is here today, Mr. Comstock was instrumental in helping me adjust to not being the superstar athlete and trying to figure out how I can harness all of that love that I have for sports and turn it into something else. He, along with Ms. Tipton, are so important to my life that now, as an adjunct teacher at DePaul, I actually use what they taught me to teach the next generation of broadcasters. That is impact. So whenever HF calls me to do something, I am all for it, and I thank you again for inviting me here. There are three things that I want to share with you that I hope that you take away from my limited time here, and I'm trying not to take up everyone's time. I know y'all got places to be. I know that everyone wants to get on with the celebration, so I'm gonna do my best to not be long-winded, but you have to give me a little bit of room. I am a solo talk show host that's used to doing a four-hour show by himself. So, doing soliloquies, it happens all the time. The number one thing that I want you to take away is it's okay if you aren't sure who or what you want to be right now. It's okay. When I was sitting in those chairs, I left HF as a Golden Apple Scholar. Wait, don't clap. That's the thing. I thought for sure what was going to happen is I was going to come back here and take over for Comstock. That's what I thought was going to happen. And then I realized that I wasn't sure that I wanted to teach. So I ended up working in radio because that was my passion. Now, the great thing about it is I'm now in a position where I'm teaching my passion. But if I would have just stayed on a road that was planned for me when I was 16 or 17 years old, I don't know if I'd get to this place. So what I'm trying to tell you is that it is fantastic to have dreams. It is fantastic to have a plan. But know that you can stray off the road. That it's okay for you to stray off of that road and explore. Because you're going to come into contact with stuff when you get into college that's going to change your mind about the direction of your life. What I'm telling you is that it's okay for you to question these things. It's okay for you to look around and see what else you are passionate about. And that you don't have to have it all figured out right now. It's a lot of pressure. You're out there filling out applications. You're hoping that these schools accept you. And you think, well, if I only get into Yale, everything's going to be perfect. I got into Yale, okay? Again, don't clap. Because I didn't go to Yale. I went to DePaul University. It was my last choice. See, now you don't want to clap. All right. Of the 8 schools that I applied to, DePaul was last on my list. I went kicking and screaming to DePaul University. I wanted to go to the University of Michigan. That was my number one goal, my dream. And I thought that it was just going to be perfect. And my parents said, we don't have enough money for that. And I was like, well, I got a little bit of a scholarship. And they were like, it's still not enough money. And so I went kicking and screaming to DePaul University. And now I can't imagine my life without that place. That place has the same significance for me that this place has. And it was the last choice. That's why I'm telling you that you don't have to have it all figured out right now. That great things can come from your ability to adapt to whatever your environment is. And you have that talent. So don't be too hard on yourself if you don't see a clear path to what your life is or isn't going to be. I'm long-winded and I apologize. I know some of this is going to sound like church. I'm just telling you that. The second thing that I want to tell you is once you do have a direction, something that you are passionate about, once you get into a professional setting, whether that's as an intern or you're working part-time somewhere, I want you to be visible. Be visible. And here's what I mean by this. I've had over the last 20 years my fair share of interns that have come through the Score or Channel 5 or NBC Sports Chicago where I work. Some of them have gone on to have great success and great fame, people that you would see on television every night, especially if you're a sports fan. And then they're the interns that at the end of their internship will ask me for a recommendation. And I don't know their names because they haven't made themselves visible. They've just been in the background. Now look, not everyone has an outward personality. Speaking in public is not very easy. But you can be visible through the way you do your work. You don't have to have an outsized personality. But if people can see your work, it is an example of who you are. So when you get these opportunities to be in front of people that are making decisions about the next thing that you end up doing, I want you to be visible. Keep that in mind. Because I know that I'm not going to write a recommendation for someone that I don't know. And if you show me just a little bit that you care about something and you want to get better at it, there is nothing I won't do for you. And I think that most people are like that. So when you get into these professional environments, ask questions, talk to people, find out what it is and why it is they are where they're at and how you can get there. Because I'm a firm believer in making sure that the people that I work with, that they're better than me. If someone will say, I want to be, no, be better. And I'm here to try and help you be better. So when you get out here, be visible. Don't just float by. If you really want it, if you want something, make sure that you talk, you are seen, you head up high, eye contact, all of those things that are important to make a great impression. Be visible and work hard. The number three thing that I want to tell you, this goes back to 1896. It's the concept of lift as you climb. You're going to be asked, because of what you've already achieved, to do great stuff. But make sure that you are bringing people up with you. Your candle doesn't burn brighter by blowing someone else's out. And I want you to know that a great way to make it burn bright is if you have a choir of candles with you. So when you get to a position where you can help someone, where you can help bring someone up, it doesn't have to even be business. It can be by being a great friend. It can be by being an advocate for people. It can be by just listening. Make sure that you lift as you climb. It is one of the guiding principles of my life and my career. I think it's really valuable. As I talked about the interns that have come through my shows, I feel wonderful that I played a role in helping them get to where they want to be. I feel the same way about my students at DePaul. I'll tell you a story, and I told you I'm going to be long-winded, and I apologize. I had a student a few years ago, my first class as an adjunct professor, and the student was clearly talented. One of the most talented students that I had, and she was doing B and C work, and I couldn't understand it, because it wasn't like the first year of my class, it was really that hard. I was just trying to figure out my way in the whole thing. So I set up a meeting with her, and I said, what's going on? Because you already know a lot of this stuff. Why am I not getting the best out of you? The student went on to tell me, and this is a broadcasting class that I teach, a media class. Student went on to tell me that another professor, he who shall not be named, told her that she wasn't pretty enough to be on television. Amazing, right? First of all, who dream kills a 19-year-old? Who tells someone that? Who tells a 19 or 20-year-old that? So she broke down. We had a good cry. We sat there and we talked strategy. And to this day, I'll never forget that student. That student and I have now become friends. She's now a peer. And I'll tell you that the moment that, I'm an emotional dude, if you haven't figured this out yet, that broke me down as an educator. I get a text message from her, and it's Dodger Stadium. I said, well, what's going on at Dodger Stadium? And this is after, you know, she's graduated. I helped her get a couple of internships. And she said, well, this is my new office. I said, oh, okay, great. That's fantastic. I said, so what's the new gig? I'm excited. And so she said, you know, I decided that instead of being in front of the camera, I'd rather just be in charge. So now that student has two league championship rings from the Los Angeles Dodgers. She is now in charge of broadcasts for the Los Angeles Dodgers. And her dream could have died in that classroom. And that's why you have to lift as you climb. You have to help bring people up. And you never know what little small thing is going to be able to help them reach their full potential. And that potential is in each and every one of you to help out in that regard. The last thing I want to tell you, I'm an old man. Good night. No, I'm kidding. The great thing is that I was an old man when I was 16. Comstock will tell you that. I've been an old man for a very long time. I am, and as I told you, I'm emotional, so I might get emotional about this. I often do when I talk to my classes at the end of a semester. I have a lot of faith in you. A lot. I'm expecting a lot from you. I am Gen X. We screwed a lot of stuff up. And we're sorry. Even if your parents don't tell you that, we're sorry. We had a lot of angst and a lot of anger. And it was righteous angst and it was righteous anger. And we didn't go as far with it as we probably should have. What gives me so much faith in you is that I'm seeing you do it. I'm seeing you take that righteous indignation and push forward. I'm seeing you challenge the establishment that we have set and our parents have set and their parents have set. And I think that those challenges are worthy. It's a good thing to be someone who questions, even questions authority. It's a good thing to be, and I hope that you don't lose that. I have a lot of faith in you, and I am counting on every one of you to make this a better place. And I think that you've got the tools to do it. You clearly have families behind you that have pushed when they needed to push. They have kicked you in the butt when they needed to kick you in the butt. They have hugged you when you needed hugs. Make sure that you thank them for that. And make sure that you take advantage of the legacy that we left you that was unfulfilled. You can do great things. And I'm so looking forward to seeing what you do next. And it's not just being a member of the National Honor Society. It's just being good people. And you all have that in you. So, when you get to college, I want you to seek out peers and mentors who have a lot of faith in you too. Those support systems are very important, and there are a lot of adults like me who want to help you. And there are a lot of adults like me that will do whatever we can to get you where you want to go. You have a great example of the people that are in your house. But know when you leave the house, there are people like that out there. Seek them out. Latch onto them. And take every bit of knowledge and experience that you can from those people. And they will be willing to give it to you. Just like Bob Comstock was willing to give it to me, just like Maggie Tipton was willing to give it to me. There are good people out there, and you're good people too. So take from them. Take everything that you can. Congratulations on your success. And I look forward to great and wonderful things. Thank you. Got the picture of me with the high top fade at the bottom. Those days are long gone.
Alright, so I'm just going to make some comments about National Honor Society in general, and then I'm going to follow it up with just some personal comments from the heart. So, to begin, the National Honor Society is the nation's premier organization established to recognize outstanding high school students. NHS chapter membership not only recognizes students for their accomplishments, but challenges them to develop further through active involvement in school activities and community service. These characteristics have been associated with membership in the organization since its beginning in 1921. Four main purposes have guided chapters of NHS from the beginning: to create enthusiasm for scholarship, to stimulate a desire to render service, to promote leadership, and to develop character in the students of secondary schools. And so that was the formal piece. And then the piece from the heart that I just want to speak to is I've had the pleasure, and maybe pleasure isn't the right word, the honor, to sponsor National Honor Society for 2 years now. And what I would like to comment on is that I am consistently just humbled and honored by our students. And a lot of times when I'm working with my NHS students, they make my whole day. So seniors, this is for you.
Exec board
members and my junior reps that you can see are around the auditorium and outside helping. Here's what I've learned from you. And my inductees, I want you to listen, because this is what you're walking into and these are the standards that you're going to uphold. So some of the things that I've learned, number one, is that I get requests for community service all over the community. So I get requests from government agencies, nonprofits, schools, places of worship, libraries. I send that out to my NHS membership. It doesn't end there. Typically, I send it out. My students volunteer, and then I start getting phone calls and emails. And I have people consistently telling me that they were just so impressed because our students were just different and set apart from what they were accustomed to. Our students, when they volunteer, when they are representing our school, they work hard, they show initiative, they're dependable, they have a positive character, they're personable, so much so that people actually feel the need to let me know and thank me. And so, seniors, I thank you. The second thing that I've learned from sponsoring NHS is that our students that are in this room, They really do desire to make the world a better place. One of the reasons why I wanted to sponsor National Honor Society was because I do enjoy community service, and I feel like it's a piece of our lives that so many of us lack, and I was hoping to reconnect with the community in that capacity. And so sometimes I will come up with ideas that I feel are probably going to be too grandiose. And I am met with nothing but enthusiasm. And I have never seen a group of students that are presented with work and are actually excited to work hard. So again, thank you. And then number three, I just want to comment, our chapter here stands out from all the other area chapters. And here is why I can say that. All through the year, whether it be August, September, holiday season, springtime, whenever anybody needs a volunteer from our school or our community, I post that out on our site, our Google sites, and we always get volunteers. Not only do we get volunteers, we get a lot of volunteers within 24 hours. The people here at our school know that if they reach out to me, I can get them NHS students who are willing to volunteer immediately and be dependable. And so I just thought this was the norm. I just thought this is what we expect and this is what all NHS students must be like. But that is not the case. We did do a regional activity where we met with a lot of sponsors from other NHS chapters from all over the area. And one of the things that the sponsors discussed amongst themselves is that they cannot get students to volunteer for events. So a lot of times students will do just the bare minimum and then that's it, and they can't get people to help for their school. And I was just so proud because that is not what we experience here. And even when students have their required 25, 35, 40, when they know that people need help, they come out and they help. And so, once again, seniors, thank you. I'm gonna miss all of you. My exec board, I'm going to miss all of you. And I look forward to what my juniors are going to bring to the table next year, and I look forward to my inductees, and I expect nothing but the best from all of you. So. With that, I'm gonna turn the mic over to, we will use her government name, Abigail Guerrero.
To the new inductees, I remember sitting in your very seat 2 years ago, recognizing the outstanding students who devoted their entirety to their community. I even thought to myself, hey, I should do that. And I did. During my junior year, I collaborated with a nonprofit organization in Chicago, and at the end of it all, earned a certificate of merit for exceptional amount of service hours. This time around, I feel very honored to pass the torch to three deserving members. If you would be so kind to help me welcome to the stage Sierra Harris, Aria Simpson, and Olivia Streetmatter. Sierra Harris is a senior here and dedicated most of her service hours to the YWCA Sexual Violence Support Services and the 2019 prom. As for our juniors, we applaud Aria Simpson, who traveled to the Dominican Republic with Gap Medics to provide nursing care in a public health hospital. And finally, Olivia Streetmatter, who contributed to the Nature Kids camps at Irons Oaks as a junior counselor. Thank you all for your time. Seniors will receive the gold cord that represents the successful completion. It's a very, very deserving award. The gold cord represents a successful completion of their NHS obligations. We'll begin with the orchestra members and follow with the senior class.
Thank you.
to have real fire, so here's some topics. The four qualities possessed by National Honor Society members are encompassed by the candle of knowledge. This candle symbolizes the eternal light of knowledge. It is the quest for knowledge that we are trying to encourage and develop in the four qualities of the National Honor Society. Through character, we are trying to foster knowledge of self and confidence in our personal beliefs and values. Through scholarship, we are trying to develop a knowledge and desire for continued learning throughout life. Through leadership and service, we are trying to encourage knowledge of social responsibility to others and their needs, as well as the courage to stand up for our beliefs. It is this light of knowledge that we pass on now to our new members of the Home of Flossmore High School chapter of the National Honor Society. The inductees will now recite the pledge after me. I pledge to uphold the high purposes of the National Honor Society to which I have been elected.
I pledge to uphold the high purposes of the National Honor Society.
And I will maintain and encourage high standards of character, scholarship, leadership, and service.
I will maintain and encourage high standards of character, scholarship,
call your name, please come forward and accept your membership certificate.
Curtis Walker, John Proga,
Devin Burke,
early. Jazz Jeffriani. Katie Harris.
Charlotte McManus. Abigail Rosales. Morgan Barber. Aaron Newman. Emma Mensa. Noelle O.
Camille Willis. Anna Wimmer. Eva White.
So thank you everybody, and once again, congratulations.